Hello everyone, myself Soumya Tiwari and welcoming you all in my YouTube channel. So today's topic is on cervical vertebra. So let's get started. So as you can see in this diagram, there are total 7 cervical vertebrae present. So the main basic features of cervical vertebrae is it is present between cranium and thoracic vertebra, and cervical vertebra is the superior portion of vertebral column, and it consists of 7 vertebrae as I have already told you. Now, cervical vertebra, CV stands for cervical vertebra. It has divided into 2 parts, as you can say, 2 types, typical and atypical cervical vertebra. So, cervical vertebra ranging from C3 to C6 is typical cervical vertebra. It means from C3 to C6 is atypical vertebra, and typical vertebra. From C3 to C6 is typical, and from C1, C2 and C7. C1, C2 and C7 is atypical cervical vertebra. Now, the main features of cervical vertebra is it has transverse foramen. What does it mean? It has foramen, a hole in its transverse process through which vertebral artery, vein and sympathetic nerve passes. And it has bifid process, spinous process, bifid spinous process. It means the spinous process is divided into 2. Yeah. Now next is it has triangular vertebral foramen. Now we will see all this through in details with diagram. So we are starting with our first cervical vertebra, C1. It is also known as atlas. Yes, you can see here, C1 is also known as atlas. And talking about the articulation, so C1 vertebra articulates superiorly with occiput, and it forms atlanto-occipital joint. It has no body, no spinous process, and has lateral masses. As you can see, it has lateral masses which has anterior arch. This is anterior arch, and has posterior. This is posterior arch, and anterior arch is defined by a tubercle present anteriorly, which is known as anterior tubercle. Same as it is, posterior arch is categorized by a tubercle present posteriorly, that is posterior tubercle. It has ring-shaped structure. And here you can see, here is the facet 4 dens. Dens is present in C2 vertebra, so it articulates anteriorly with facet 4 dens, which is present in C1, and posteriorly dens is articulated with, here is your transverse ligament. So now next vertebra is C2 vertebra. It is also known as axis, and it has special feature, that is odontoid process, or you can say dens. Here is a diagram of C2 vertebra. So it is dens which articulate with the anterior arch of atlas and form atlanto-axial joint, medial atlanto-axial joint. It has superior articular facet which articulates with the inferior articular facet of C1, that is atlas, and it forms 2 lateral atlanto-axial joint. It has vertebral arch, that means it has pedicle and lamina, and lamina is thicker and stronger. It has also spinous process which is large, thick, strong and bifid. Now coming to C7 cervical vertebra. So it is also known as vertebral prominence, and it has long spinous process, as you can see in this picture, and the spinous process is thick, long and horizontal, which you can easily palpate. Now Anterior tubercle is absent in C7 vertebra, but you can see posterior tubercle is present and spinous process is not bifid. So, typical cervical vertebra consist of from C3 to C6. This is known as typical cervical vertebra. So, all typical cervical vertebra have similar common feature. So, let's discuss one by one. Here's a diagram of typical cervical vertebra. So, starting with the body. Here you can see the body. It is small and broader from side to side. Its superior surface is concave transversely concave superior surface, and inferior surface is saddle shape. It means both convex and concave structure present on inferior surface. So convex from side to side and concave from before backward. Now coming to vertebral foramen. Here is the vertebral foramen which you can see. It's triangular in structure and it is larger than body. If you compare the size of body and vertebral foramen, and third point, it has transverse foramen, a hole in its transverse process. Anterior tubercle of C6 vertebra is large and it is also known as carotid tubercle. So there might be a chances of compression against carotid artery, and you can see the spine is short and it is bifid. It means it is divided into two. So these are all the common features of all typical vertebras. So here is a summary. There are total 7 cervical vertebra, in which from C3 to C6 is typical, and C1, C2 and C7 is atypical cervical vertebra. There are 2 joints mainly present in cervical vertebra: atlanto-occipital joint, which allow you to say yes, the nodding movement, and the atlanto-axial joint, which allow you to say no. That means the rotation occurs at atlanto-axial joint. That means 50% of flexion and extensions occur at atlanto-occipital joint, and 50% rotation occurs at C1 and C2.